Hello dear students, today we are talking on Cost and Works Accounting Special Paper 3, topic Marginal Costing. Today we will see the new numerical question of the marginal costing. Before that, if you are new to my channel, I request you to subscribe the YouTube channel for the latest and updated videos regarding Cost and Works Accounting. Now let's move to the question. Here, the data have been obtained from the records of the manufacturing firm. And here the data is something different. The data regarding two periods is given. That is, first one, sales for the period 1 is 3 lakh, for period 2 is 3,20,000, and the total cost for the period 1 is 2,60,000 and 2,72,000. And they have asked us to calculate the break-even sales, profit when sales are rupees 3,60,000, and the third is sales required to earn a profit of rupees 50,000. Here the information is different. It means that we have to use the different formulas to calculate the break-even point as well as profit and sales. As there is no information regarding variable cost and fixed cost in the question, we need to calculate it with the help of the different formulas regarding PV ratio as well as for the contribution. Now, just keep in mind all the figures regarding period 1 and period 2 so that it will be helpful for you for the next calculation regarding solution of the question. So for to calculate the break-even sales, we have a formula. Break-even sales is equal to fixed cost upon PV ratio. It means here, as we don't know the fixed cost as well as the PV ratio, so first of all, we will calculate the profit volume ratio. But to calculate the profit volume ratio, as you know, the formula for PV ratio is contribution divided by sales into 100. But to calculate the contribution, we require variable cost, as it is not given in the question. Therefore, we will use the different formula to calculate profit volume ratio. Let's see. So first of all, profit volume ratio is equal to, we have to use the different formula, that is change in profit divided by change in sales multiplied by 100. Now, how to calculate the change in profit? That is profit of the second period minus profit of the first period. It means there is an absolute change of 8,000 rupees. Similarly, change in sales, sales of the second period and minus change of the first period. So the absolute change in sales is rupees 20,000. So if you put these figures into the formula, automatically you will get the change in profit upon change in sales multiplied by 100. That is 8,000 divided by 20,000 multiplied by 100. You will get the profit volume ratio of rupees ratio 40%. Now, out of the break-even point, one contained, that is PV ratio, we have calculated. Now similarly, we have to calculate the contribution, because to calculate the break-even point, PV ratio and contribution is required. Therefore, for contribution, we have a formula, sales multiplied by PV ratio. As you know, sales for the period 1 is rupees 3 lakh. Therefore, 3 lakh multiplied by 40% is equal to contribution is 1,20,000. As we have profit volume ratio as well as the contribution, now we will calculate the break-even point. And therefore, break-even point is equal to fixed cost divided by PV ratio. And to calculate the fixed cost, we have a formula, contribution minus profit. As contribution calculated is 1,20,000, here it is mentioned. And the profit of the first year is 40,000, which is given in the question. Therefore, 1,20,000 minus 40,000, fixed cost is rupees 80,000. And therefore, BP is equal to fixed cost here 10 is missing, 80,000 divided by 40 multiplied by 100, so that you will get the break-even point, and that is 2 lakh. Here the figure is 80,000. So 80,000 divided by 40 multiplied by 100 is equal to rupees 2 lakh. Now, if you move on to the next, the second question they have asked us to calculate the profit when sales are rupees 3,60,000. As you know, we have to calculate the profit. Therefore, we have to put the formula of profit. As you know, profit, to calculate the profit, profit is equal to fixed cost minus contribution. So here, contribution, when sales are 3,60,000. So 3,60,000 minus PV ratio, because contribution is equal to sales into PV ratio. So here, sales, new sales have taken 3,60,000 multiplied by 40% is equal to contribution is 1,44,000. And therefore, to calculate the profit, contribution is equal to, that is 1,44,000 minus fixed cost, as we have calculated fixed cost is 80,000. Therefore, 1,44,000 minus 80,000, the profit is equal to 64,000. And the third question that was asked is, we have to calculate the sales to earn a profit of rupees 50,000. It means when profit will be 50,000, how much would be the sales? And to calculate the sales, first of all, we require the contribution. Therefore, contribution is equal to fixed cost plus profit required, that is desired profit. So here, fixed cost, as you know, 80,000 is our fixed cost, and the desired profit required is 50,000. Therefore, contribution is 1,30,000. And hence, sales is equal to contribution multiplied by PV ratio. Therefore, 1,30,000 multiplied by 40% is equal to sales is 3,25,000. So dear students, this was a different question having the different kind of information and using the different formula that we have earlier calculated. They were something different, but this is a very simple and easy problem to understand. Once you practice at your home in your notebook, it will be easy for you to understand. But even though, if you have any of the queries or the doubt regarding this question, you can comment me or chat me in the Google Classroom. And if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you.